Hi, my name is Stephanie, and today I want to talk to you about diagnostic manuals. So professionals use diagnostic manuals as guides to help them when diagnosing, and this includes when evaluating for autism. Diagnostic manuals are more officially called diagnostic classification systems. There are two major ones in use, the DSM and the ICD. The DSM is the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, published by the American Psychiatric Association. The most current version is the DSM-5-TR, TR just meaning text revision. This is the diagnostic manual used in the United States for diagnosing psychiatric conditions. There are some other countries that also use the DSM, including Australia, New Zealand, and Canada. When people are talking about autism, Asperger's, PDD-NOS, etc., a lot of times, especially if they're American, they're referencing some of the older terms used in the DSM-4, the prior edition. The current edition instead takes all of these and puts them under one category, autism spectrum disorders, and instead establishes support levels. So when I'm talking about criteria, I'm almost always referencing the DSM because that is the diagnostic manual that the professionals use in my country. However, there is another diagnostic manual that is popularly used around the world, and that is the ICD, which is currently in its 11th edition. However, many countries are still using the 10th because it's pretty new and carrying over in codes and such takes time. ICD stands for International Classification of Diseases, and it is published by the World Health Organization. Now, as the name implies, the ICD actually is involved in more than just diagnosing psychiatric conditions, and because of this, ICD codes are actually used in the US healthcare system as well. Now, the ICD is actually considered to be much more accessible than the DSM. It's usually low cost, it's provided in multiple languages, and online, it's actually free. Most countries across the world use the ICD, and many use it particularly to be able to code for cause of death reports. The DSM-5-TR and the ICD-11 track very closely in diagnostic criteria, especially when we're talking about autism. There had been a lot of confusion because the ICD-10 still used Asperger's as a separate diagnosis, and this would often result in people who use the DSM attacking people who use the ICD because they thought that they were using outdated language, but in their country, Asperger's was still the current correct diagnosis. Now, the ICD-11 does follow what the DSM-5 did in putting Asperger's and some other conditions all together as autism spectrum disorder. There are some explanatory differences between the ICD and the DSM when it comes to autism spectrum disorder, and I feel like the ICD-11 does a better job of fully explaining things. This means that although the criteria is very similar, the technicalities of criteria, the explanations, examples, etc., might look a little bit different between America and countries that use the DSM and those that use the ICD. This can also give us a broader picture of what autism is understood to be. In the future, I personally would like to go over the criteria and explanations in the ICD-11 for autism spectrum disorder, because I've already done that for the DSM-5. I think it would help more people in other countries as well, because they probably don't follow the DSM. Anyway, I just wanted to provide a brief explanation of diagnostic manuals and the different ones that are popularly used and why there might be some disparity between definitions and stuff like that. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed it or found it useful, informative, whatever. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. And if you're interested in autism-related content from me, you can go ahead and hit that subscribe button. I try to upload every Thursday at 4 p.m. Central Standard Time, but that doesn't always happen.
Thank you to everyone who supports me here on YouTube as YouTube channel members, through Ko-fi, and as patrons on Patreon. And a special thank you to my spinny stimmy tier patron, Jack Varney.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having a wonderful week, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!